It's Monday, March 10th, and here's some of the news beyond the headlines. Libya's Prime Minister Ali Zidane has threatened to bomb a North Korean-flagged tanker if it tries to export oil from a rebel-controlled port. Separatist militants said they started loading oil onto the tanker at the Sidra port east of Tripoli. Rebels have seized three major ports since August, demanding greater political autonomy and a larger share of oil profits. These seizures impact the government's ability to revive oil exports. Oil is the driving force behind Libya's economy. Oil and gas production make up 65% of the country's GDP, 96% of exports, and 98% of government revenues. Libyan officials call the rebel export of oil an act of piracy. A group of Serbian war vets have turned up in Crimea to lend a hand in the ongoing Russian occupation of the peninsula.
Srbi i Rusi su se uvek ispomagali kroz vekove. Znači, Rusi su uvek dolazili kao dobrovoljci u srpske ratove i kad je nama bilo teško, tako smo mi sad došli njima da pomognemo. I mi smo isto takođe njima dolazili.
The Serbian volunteers are part of the ultra-nationalist Chetnik movement of Serbia, a self-styled militia that models itself on Serbian rebels who fought the Ottoman Empire. These days, they're better known for having links to the ethnic cleansing that took place during the Yugoslav wars of the 1990s. Now that they're in Crimea, there are questions over just what sort of help they want to provide to Russia supporters in their conflict with Ukraine. Syrian President Bashar al-Assad seems to be gearing up for his re-election, even as the Syrian civil war continues around him for its third year. Reuters reports fresh government-organized political demonstrations in Damascus, which call on Assad to nominate himself in the upcoming presidential election. 18 months ago, it seemed like Assad was losing control over Damascus as rebels gained ground around the capital. But since then, government forces have regained control in central Syria. Rebels and some Western leaders insist Assad's departure is a precondition for any peace deal. Assad has yet to announce that he's seeking a third term in elections that are supposed to be held by July. U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement confirmed that at least 750 detainees at the Northwest Detention Center in Washington State are on a hunger strike. The detainees, who are paid a dollar a day for the work they do, cleaning and maintaining the very facility in which they are being held, have refused to eat since Friday. They're demanding safer working conditions, better food, and that President Barack Obama sign an executive order ending deportations. These 750 detainees are part of a growing national campaign against the U.S. immigration policy. Check out the Vice News YouTube channel to watch our latest original reporting and documentaries from around the world.
Уралом, как вы видите, пробили ворота. Произошло проникновение на территорию вооруженных военнослужащих.
I got it. I got it. I got it.